So guys, in order to make this hop-up test, I decided to change the hop-up I have on my main sniper. As you can see, this is the setup right now. I'm using a fast hop. I'm keeping all these kits together because I have this one ready. It's a flooded barrel I'm planning to use. So let's start by assembling our hop up, which is this one. Let's see all those parts in here. This is the main unit. Unscrew this. Lots of tiny bits, but once they come together, the quality is perfect. But watch out not to lose anything, guys. What we have here, it's a 60 degree knob with a very cool design. It has these ears, I would say, that it's very easy to align it, be totally straight, no issues. We have three different arms, S1, S2 and S3. This is the S1. This is the S2. What's the difference here? And this is the S3. S3 can be used with these two knobs. For more detailed photos, you can visit my Instagram or Skirmshop Instagram. Anyway, for my build, I'll be using the S1, I believe. We also have some O-rings. We have some screws, little spring. Every one of these bits has its own work to do, so make sure you use all of them. The barrel I'm using here is a TNT. Now we have our barrel. First thing to do is insert our rubber. Easy as that, but maybe, yes. Let's remove this. Because our hop-up rubber already has a groove, and it will go in here and everything will be in total order. Make sure it's totally clear in case you have such barrel, because Stalker has predicted all of this and you don't need anything else apart from these parts he includes in the set. This barrel was R-hopped with the fast hop and I was very disappointed of the results. Okay, now it's clear. It goes inside the groove, just in place. Next thing to do is insert this part. Our top side is this one. So simply slide. No lube needed, no nothing. Then you take the dial, insert of course this O-ring. Nothing difficult. Just make sure it goes in. as I said, nothing difficult, but my hands are, anyway. Come on! Yep, there you go. And let's use a little bit of lube here. Like this. Doesn't have anything to do with our inner barrel, so don't worry. We'll use a bit more. Okay, let's go like this. And do you see this white line here, number 6? Align it with the white line you can see on the top of the hop up. This way the arm goes at the higher point, it's easier to install. Okay, so after this, next step. Take this one. Let's go all the way in. Align. Slight push. Look at this, guys. Without any effort, we know that our barrel is absolutely aligned to the hop-up unit. Now, let's take those screws, the small ones. Once it's in place, we just have to tighten it just a little bit. No need to push. Okay, there you go. One, two, and three at the bottom. We use the small ones. Just tighten a bit, then go all around, make sure, and it's over. Now we have this small o-ring, you must not forget it. It goes here. This went in easier. Okay, let's hope not to make any damage. Very, very tiny amount of lube here, please, guys. Tiny amount. Okay, very nice. And then you decide which arm you are going to use. S1, S2, S3. I'll go for S2 because I like that it's much bigger touch with the BB. Let's go for S2. Go here. Slide from this side first. Oh my god, I almost forgot. We have to install the spring. Little bit of lube goes down here just to make it stick in this hole. Come on, don't want to lose this. Use a tool or something like this. Just has to stand there. There you go, thanks a lot. Push. Okay. Keep it in place. Now, take this tiny part, it's the... Okay. Just move a little bit front and rear the arm. And you need a flathead, small one. And there you go. Guys, we are ready. This is it. The last thing you have to do is use this big o-ring. Go here from the front all the way back. Please do not forget this. Okay. And last but not least, final two screws, the large ones, go to the sides and keep the barrel in place. This is, I believe, the most dangerous part, because I've heard of guys destroying their barrels by over tightening these. Oh my god, my English sucks. Okay, just a little bit. It will not go anywhere. For these two, I would advise you to use Loctite. And I'll do it right now. So, be right back, guys. I'm using the blue one. Because of your shots, maybe the barrel moves or the screw moves and untightens. This way you can have your... Okay. Okay, after you finish this, we can watch through the barrel, make sure that our hop-up arm works, the hop-up dial works, everything is in place. Okay, let's see. We are now to zero, because it was the first time we used it. Let's go from zero to 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I can see through the barrel that it hops. I like the way it's aligned. Watch through a light or something to make sure. You can also push from the top and see how it comes inside the barrel. Okay, oh my god, guys, it's so perfect. Now, take your barrel. These two holes here are the position you were supposed to have your hop up, the old one. Push inside. What I do to make sure it's everything is aligned is I remove the screw. I take my my sniper. I know this side is the upper one. Go down here. Check that it's in position. And then go to the other side. Try to lock your outer barrel to see if it's in the correct spot. Yeah, it's locked, so everything is aligned. Unlock again. Take it out. And now you can safely tighten the screw here, and everything is ready to be installed in the rifle. Just a tiny bit here. Okay, one screwed. One last check that our hop-up works. Okay, of course it works. We are at 7, 6. Okay, let's leave it. I believe 4 is... Yeah, 4 is okay. Let's install it here. Oh my god, I love it. Apart from the build quality, it's also very, very beautiful. Look at this. Okay, perfect. How did I do this? Lock in place. tighten this here. And of course, for this rifle, I'll be using the Stalker cylinder and the Stalker piston. Try doing this as I did here, guys. I'll install the rail later. Let's go and install this one. I used Loctite to this one and I can't remove it now. Oh my god. Tighten it. Put this back. Very nice. Use this sexy beast here. Rapax Hulk. Our spring guide by Stalker. Thanks to Skirmshop. Thank you guys again. This will be tough. I know it. Oh, okay. Went back in position perfectly. Let's use our cap again. And let's see the results. .48 BBs. Oh my fucking god. 3 Oh my god. 391. Oh my god. So silent. Oh my god. Oh my god, it's approximately 4 joules. 4 joules with these things here. Guys, oh my god. And it's so nice. So nice. So, thanks again, guys. The products are perfect. I love the build quality. I like all this stuff. Because of my field rules, this will go down to 3.3 joules approximately, but with all these parts here, it's guaranteed that I can make it very, very easily. And stay tuned, guys, for more photos on my Instagram. Check out Skirmshop, guys, and see ya. Thanks a lot.